What do pizza boxes, your outdoor gear, skis, carpets, and photo paper have in common? Probably this four-letter word, PFAS.
PFAS are one of the most threatening chemicals ever invented.
Now that we're finally becoming aware that these chemicals exist, that we've been exposed without our knowledge for decades and decades.
PFAS pose a serious risk to health and the environment, and worst of all, they never degrade. For this reason, they're also called forever chemicals. And they have an impact on practically all of us. Per- and polyfluoroalkyl substances, or PFAS, is an umbrella term for over 4,000 different chemicals. They do a brilliant job of repelling water, grease, and dirt, superior to any other substance, which is why nearly every branch of industry uses them. We find them in everything from non-stick cookware, artificial leather, furniture, fire retardants, cleaning liquids, electronics, makeup, cars, pesticides, soils, drinking water, and our food. They are literally everywhere.
They're being found in soils all over the planet, in living things all over the planet, in the blood of animals, including polar bears, even in Arctic ice cap, and in the blood of humans all over the planet, including babies that are being born.
This is Robert Billot. PFAS became the story of his life, but more on that later. PFAS enter the soils and water sources via landfill discharge, emissions from industrial facilities, commercial wastewater, or simply by washing our rain jacket. Most wastewater treatment plants can't filter them. This map shows more than 2,000 contaminated sites in the US, polluting the drinking water of an estimated 200 million people. Studies showed the presence of PFAS in almost all breast milk samples taken from women in India, Indonesia, and the Philippines. So does that mean I myself am affected too? I had my blood checked to find out. Not an easy undertaking. Only a few specialist laboratories can do PFAS analyses.
The main problem of this substance is that the regularity is the exposure not very high. We have no high acute exposure, but the substances are very persistent, so it can accumulate in the body. And that is the main problem, that at the end they may accumulate in a dose which might be then a problematic concentration.
This is Professor Thomas Goehn from the Institute of Occupational, Social and Environmental Medicine in Erlangen, Germany. High concentrations can lead to increased liver weight and even cause cancer. Kidneys are at risk too. PFAS can also affect sperm quality, while the birth weight of newborns can likewise be lowered. How the substances actually work in the body is unclear. According to one hypothesis, they restructure cell barriers. What scientists do know is that the immune response is lowered. A recent study linked PFAS accumulation in the lungs to increased severity of COVID-19 infections. And in general, vaccines can be rendered less effective. Of course, PFAS are also found in my blood. 4 nanograms per liter, 1/1000th of the weight of a grain of sand. That doesn't really sound much. Still, I'm worried. Am I in danger of getting cancer?
There seems to be no risk from the knowledge we have today. So this is okay, but of course, if you have some higher exposure, there might be started some risk to some effects.
Apparently so far I'm fine, but who knows how they will accumulate during the next 20 years. The characteristics that make PFAS so great for products from food packaging to waterproof footwear is also what makes them so dangerous. Forever chemicals is no exaggeration. This model shows PFOA, one of the most researched and commonly found PFAS. It is also contained in my body. The carbon and fluorine atoms form among the strongest chemical bonds in organic chemistry. That's why they don't degrade and can only be destroyed by exposing them to extremely high temperatures, over 1,000 degrees Celsius, for 2 seconds. One of the first PFAS was discovered by accident in 1938 by researchers working for chemical giant DuPont. What made it special was its corrosion resistance, which is why it was used for valves in the first nuclear bomb.
I've got great news for you, and it's right under this macaroni and cheese. Now, glass ovenware comes with a Teflon finish. So now glass is not the cleanup problem it used to be.
After the Second World War, PFAS found a more everyday use in the kitchen. It became famous in the coating for non-stick pans under the brand name Teflon.
Right?
Right!
And it was soon being used everywhere. A success story, until a farmer in the US noticed that something was wrong with his cattle.
He could see their teeth turning black. He could see them wasting away and dropping dead.
Robert Billot represented the farmer in a 20-year-long legal battle against the multinational.
Was the wildlife in the area, the deer, the fish, the birds. And he thought that he himself and his family was getting sick. And he was convinced he knew what was happening. He could see white foaming water coming out of a landfill next to his property.
It is today probably the biggest legal case in history concerning PFAS contamination, and even inspired the movie Dark Waters.
How many did you lose?
190.
190 cows.
You tell me, nothing's wrong here.
Subsequent investigations revealed that thousands of people in Parkersburg and along the entire Ohio River were contaminated. Between 1951 and 2003, almost 800 tons of PFOA, that special type of forever chemical that also was found in my blood, were discharged by DuPont. Documents show the company has known for decades that these substances are highly toxic, but they didn't inform anybody or halt the production with forever chemicals and their subsequent release.
That there could be something really toxic, hazardous in that water, and that it was being covered up, and that the public wasn't being told, and that the state and federal regulators didn't even know what was happening. It took me a long time to start to believe that that really could be happening.
According to DuPont, the company agreed to pay $671 million to settle thousands of personal injury lawsuits. This and similar cases in Italy and the Netherlands didn't go unnoticed, and PFAS like PFOA were banned in the EU, the US, and Japan. Except...
And what we saw happen is the company started switching to what they called safe alternative PFAS chemicals, things with a couple of fewer carbons.
This means they just have shorter molecules. In effect, a new generation of PFAS was invented, which aren't yet regulated. But scientists suspect they are just as hazardous as their predecessors.
They are. Very big problem is that they are more mobile and that they are very, very difficult to get removed from the drinking water. And they are easily going into plants. This means they can go into vegetables or fruits with the water.
Dr. Roland Weber works as a consultant for international institutions like the UN on all matters regarding persistent organic pollutants. The EU is thinking about banning all forever chemicals, except for essential ones like those used in medical equipment. At the same time, their use in Asian countries like China, India, and Indonesia is increasing. So what can be done? As individuals, we can avoid packaged fast food and frozen food, microwave popcorn, non-stick cookware, or install an activated carbon filter to remove certain PFAS from our tap water. After pressure from a Greenpeace detox campaign, some outdoor gear brands like Vought, Paramo and Rotauf removed forever chemicals from their production chain, as did Swedish furniture giant IKEA.
I mean, a requirement to label products if they contain PFAS would be great, but it's not there. I mean, even for the most problematic ones, today you do not have a label if they are containing PFOA. So I think here there is much to do for regulatory bodies.
Instead of banning individual PFAS like in the past, countries like Germany, Denmark, Norway and Sweden are pushing to phase out all forever chemicals by 2030. Potentially a decisive step towards preventing excessive levels in our water in the most remote areas of the world like the Antarctic and in our bodies.
If you like the story, give us a like or comment here below, or subscribe to our channel. We come up with new videos every Friday.